Imagine a chip that runs Arduino on one core, Linux on the other, and is built on RISC-V architecture, all for around $10. Sounds like science fiction? Well, it's not. This might just be the next big leap after Arduino, Espressif, and Raspberry Pi. Gritty YouTubers, here is the guy with the Swiss accent, bringing you a new episode with fresh ideas around sensors and microcontrollers. Remember, if you subscribe, you'll always sit in the front row. Cheap chips and modules mainly made in China. Open source toolchains, development platforms and projects. Platforms like Arduino, Espressif and Raspberry Pi that linked the two together and created ecosystems including communities. Raspberry Pis move upmarket and towards commercial usage, creating space for new innovators. The rise of RISC-V bringing open source to the chip level. RISC-V is rapidly gaining traction, with Espressif and other manufacturers introducing new, complex chips and boards capable of running even Linux. Toolchains and projects have also started adopting RISC-V, which has created fertile ground for the next big thing. Don't believe me? Let's dive in. On the low end, WCH created the CH32V003, a 32-bit RISC-V chip that costs just cents and can be programmed with the Arduino IDE. At the other end, LuckFox and MilkV have introduced intriguing Linux ports. Today we focus on the MilkV Duo. This little marvel features dual RISC-V processors, one running Arduino or RTOS, the other Linux. The small ones are the size of a Pi Pico, are SD card bootable, connectable through Ethernet and USB connectors, and expandable with a camera adapter. Here I have the 64 MB version. A 256 MB version is also available, as is an upgraded Duo S with lots of headers, Ethernet, optional Wi-Fi, and optional eMMC. So far, I have not been able to get one. They were sold out. Every chip includes at least a 1 GHz and a 700 MHz C906 RISC-V processor, plus an AT51 MCU core. The bigger models add an ARM A53 core. We'll focus on the two RISC-V cores for this video. All processors are linked via the AMBA bus to the peripherals, so we can blink the same LED from one or the other core. In our case, we can blink it from Linux or Arduino because we will run Linux on the 1 GHz CPU and Arduino code on the 700 MHz CPU. It has plenty of peripherals, including video and audio subsystems, as well as the usual GPIOs, ADCs, PWM pins, I2C and SPI interfaces, known from our MCUs. Very interesting. First, download and burn the OS image from MilkV's GitHub. Unfortunately, Arduino functionality is currently only supported by the 1.09 version, not the newest 1.10. Use Pi Imager to write it to an SD card, insert it into the Duo, and connect it via USB-C to your PC. You should see two new devices in your device manager, a serial port and a USB RNDIS network adapter. You may need to install the network adapter driver the first time. Everything is described in the setting up chapter. The onboard LED blinks, but which core is blinking it? Let's find out. Install the latest Arduino IDE, add this JSON file to the Preferences tab, and install the SG200X port in the Boards Manager. Now you can select the standard Duo and its 256 MB version. Start with the blink sketch. But which pin should we blink? Fortunately, we find the Duo pinout in the manual. For Arduino, we have to use the GPIO columns. At the bottom, we find that the LED is connected to GPIO 0. So far, everything is similar to all other Arduino boards. But wait, here we see that Linux is already blinking the LED. To stop it, rename the blink script and reboot. Now Linux can't find it and the blinking stops. We can later look at the blink file. Do you remember? The board created a serial connector on our PC. This is the one we will use to upload our Arduino sketch. If you press upload, you will be astonished at how fast it compiles. The upload takes the usual time. Now the LED blinks with your timing. Cool! Our board behaves like any other Arduino board. Just compiling is extremely fast. Use the RNDIS adapter's IP address and a terminal emulator, like PuTTY or MOBA Xterm, to connect to it. But what is its IP address? IPconfig reveals the secret. It created a new network on our PC. Its address is 192.168.42.1. If we ping it, we see that it is alive. Obviously, it has no internet connection because it is only connected to my PC. The username is root and the password is milk5, by the way. Because it has BusyBox, a collection of Linux commands, installed, we can check the initial blink script using cat or vi. There is nothing special, with one exception. The LED pin has the number 440, not GPIO0. Very confusing. Fortunately, I found this much bigger pinout diagram where we find pin 440. For Linux, it seems we have to use the num column. But it's not the end of the confusion, as we will later see. Because Python is also installed, we can blink the LED again using the pinpong library. The LED in Python is on GP25. So this time we have to use the column pinname. We have now blinked the LED with Arduino, Bash and Python. First we try the built-in ADC and connect it to a potentiometer, creating a variable voltage between 0 and 3.3 volts. The example file takes the 10-bit value from the ADC to set the delay for a blink sketch. The lower the voltage, the faster the blinking. Yes, it works. Next level up, an HC-S04 ultrasonic distance sensor. Keep in mind that these new chips use 3.3 volt and are not 5 volt tolerant. So I use a 3.3 volt variant of the ultrasonic sensor. Otherwise, you need a level converter. Also, this one works. Next up is I2C with this SSD 1306 display. After copying the sketch and the libraries to the respective folders, it works. And these funny eyes watch us. All examples work seamlessly. However, the serial monitor doesn't function yet. So we use a USB to serial adapter connected to pins 6 and 7 for output. I hope this will be corrected soon. Now we have one terminal connected to the Arduino core using serial and the other connected to Linux using TCP/IP. They even provide an example of transferring messages from Arduino to Linux, which creates new possibilities. Enough blinking and sensors. As usual on this channel, we want more. So I connect an $11 camera to the $11 board. Not too complicated if you insert the ribbon cable the right way. If we start the pre-installed cameratest.sh, open the VLC player on our PC, enter this link and reduce the caching value in the Show More options, we see the video in HD quality on our PC. This small board can stream video and execute Arduino code simultaneously. But something is lacking. We could now explore image recognition with artificial intelligence, or we could connect the Duo to the home network using Ethernet. I tried image recognition, set up an Ubuntu virtual machine, installed a toolchain, and cross-compiled the programs, all on my Proxmox home server, shown in video number 443. Not going the Pi5 route proved again a good decision. These possibilities are extremely cool, but they are too complex for today's video. So we extend our webcam and connect it to my home network, not just to my PC. For that purpose, I use this I/O board with an RJ45 connector. Unfortunately, I did not find much information about this board. I would definitely like some accessible I/O pins. But we can enable the Ethernet as well as the USB connectors. First, we add a fixed MAC address and reboot. This address has to be different from all the others in your network. We can also enable the four USB connectors if we like. Now I place the Duo on the I/O board and connect it with an Ethernet cable to the router. By the way, the RNDIS adapter is no longer available now. And really, advanced IP scanner finds the assigned MAC address and its IP address. Cool! It is connected to my home network. Let's quickly check the camera. We start the server as before. But now I change the IP address. Now we can watch the stream via my home network. We have created a $22 webcam with plenty of additional possibilities. Of course, this time we can ping google.com because we are connected to the internet. And it could run Arduino code in parallel, with a radar sensor, for example. The project is already well documented, so I hope, of course, that some cool projects start to support this platform. Maybe we will get an alternative to the Raspberry Pi Zero. It has some potential for the lower end, and it is definitely one of the coolest platforms to play with. RISC-V is driving exciting new developments in our community. Cheap 32-bit RISC-V chips are here supported by Arduino IDE. On Linux, LuckFox and MilkV started to create innovative boards. MilkV Duo combines Linux and Arduino in one powerful package. From sensor applications on the Arduino core to streaming video on Linux, the possibilities are endless. One last thing. You do not need an I/O board to connect your Duo to the internet. This simple RJ45 connector works perfectly. Just make sure you get one made for the Duo to avoid any pin-out issues. For just an additional $3 or so, you've got an Ethernet-connected Duo. That was all for today. As always, you find all the relevant links in the description. If you found this video useful or interesting, please support the channel. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye!